Hey friends, tonight we're hanging out at Give Kids the World Village, and it is a night of a million lights. This is an amazing event that they actually host here, and it's one of the few times that you get to come and explore the village itself, and they invited us out to show you and talk about how amazing the village is. Anywho's, let's go do this.
Well, this is a beautiful start. Seriously, I love Christmas lights, and I love Christmas lights with Christmas music, and putting them together is a perfect combination.
Last year was the first ever Night of a Million Lights, and Walt Disney World donated 3 million lights to the Give Kids the World Village, and we are back again this year, and it's much more improved. They have more people here, and if you just heard Pam, who is actually the CEO of Give Kids the World Village, there are 50 families here. Last year we were here, no families, and we had to wear face masks, and it's just amazing how everything is getting back together, and there's families coming down here, making their wishes, and enjoying the village. It makes me really happy.
On earth, I'd rather be than here at the village. So marrying the two of them and get to share it with you is just like a dream come true. So thank you so much. We're glad you're here to help us celebrate what we're calling Night of a Million Lights 2, because it's going to be a little different, and you're going to see some things that are different this year. First and foremost, we're so excited because, of course, last year we were in the throes of the pandemic, and the biggest worry was having everybody to keep their mask on. That was our biggest challenge for 52 nights, was reminding people to keep their mask on, and we didn't have any families here. But this year we've got, oh my goodness, close to 50 families here on property with us, and it's just so amazing. And that's what we do, and that's why we're so anxious to get back to, is to see those numbers keep growing and serving more and more families. So what you're going to see is different is last year, of course, for those of you who are here, you were able to walk and stroll through the entire village. This year, it's even more spectacular than last year. As you look around, we've got this section of the village, which wasn't decorated last year. In a few minutes, you're going to see it do some amazing things. And then after you experience this, and we've got some great desserts for you, you can go through our marketplace and have some more food and look at the great merchandise we have. We did our first Night of a Million Lights. We were sitting around like a few weeks before and going, wouldn't it be really cool if maybe 10 to 15,000 people actually came and experienced the lights over the 52 nights? And you guys, last year, because of embracing it and blogging about it and writing about it and tweeting about it and Instagramming about it and all those incredible things that you do as influencers, because of you, we welcome 90,400 people because of what you did after you left here last year by promoting it and talking about it. It was amazing. See a magic button over there that's gonna help do it. You wanna take a stroll over there and let's see what we can do. I bet you that you can make some magic with me, right? But it's you're the one that's gonna have all the magic. So right there, here's the button. Right here, okay? And we're gonna help the, have the crowd help us count backwards from three, okay? And when we get to one, I want you to push the button and let's see what happens. Are we ready? You guys ready to help us count? Help Kaysen count? Okay. Three, two,
one.
Oh, look what she did.
It was a magical place on a magical night. The season surrounds with a warm wintry glow as stars in the sky shine on blankets of snow. But what to our wandering eyes should appear but our village of dreamers shining all through the year?
Tickets for this event are $25 to $40, depending on the night. you know what I mean, as it gets into peak season and holiday season. And like I said, it doesn't matter if it's worth it or not. I mean, it is worth it because it is such a cool experience, but it's just good to actually put that amazing like money to good use and spend it at a wonderful place like Give Kids the World Village.
Before we move along, we got to say hello to Mayor Clayton and Miss Mary here, and now we're gonna actually jump aboard a tram to tour around the village. But I love them, aren't they so cute? It is like the Osborne lights are back, but on a grander scale. Look at this.
I am loving the music as I'm just walking around with all the houses so decorated, beautiful. Oh.
One of my all-time favorite songs right here. Holy moly. Boston Market is actually sponsoring one of the houses here, so you can have some Boston Market at Give Kids the World. I mean, that would be really cool. I don't know if it's actually Boston Market. I think it is because it's got chicken pot pie. So you can get some Boston Market here and look at pretty lights. That is, honestly, I'm really impressed with that.
I might actually get myself a chicken pot pie. Why not? A Boston Market chicken pot pie? I haven't had a Boston Market in such a long time. It's very nice that they actually sponsor one of the houses. Actually, all of the houses here are actually sponsored by some amazing companies, and I really love it. The Diz, Dreams Unlimited Travel has one, The Lost Bros has one, Home Depot, some major, major companies, some of them within the theme park community, and it's really cool to see everybody pull together for a great cause, you know what I mean?
I know that there is a Boston Market like kind of up the street there, so they must actually just be bringing these over. Like, look at this. Honestly, it is a whole Boston Market chicken pot pie right here. This reminds me of Michael Scott. I promise you, when I showed up here today, I was not expecting a chicken pot pie, but I think we're gonna have to dive. Oh, look at that. I like it when you actually get a bunch of chicken as soon as you actually pull out. Oh, wow. This
little bit of chicken fried. What's chicken pot pie? Little bit of chicken pot pie. Cold beer on a Friday night. I dropped the pee.
I can honestly say this is a very delicious pot pie. And it's actually hot too. Like, you think actually it being like brought over from the restaurant or picked up that it would actually get cold, but no, it's all there. It's good. It's open. We could actually grab ourselves an icy if we wanted to wash down our chicken pot pie. Like I said, it's really cool that they have all these offerings, and you can actually take advantage of these too. So when you come, they have the menus all out there and you get to enjoy. And like I said, everything goes to a good cause.
They actually have an elf icy, so I asked them to give me a little bit so I could try it, and I think it's like a cherry lime, but you know, you're in the Christmas mood, so we gotta try all the Christmas festivities, and I've never had an elf icy before, so here we go, we'll try it out. That's good. It's tang.
This is a look at a map of the village, and you can see it is massive. We are right here. Because you can see they got Boston Market, we got Icy, and then right next door is Santa. We can go meet Santa, and then we're gonna go walk around and explore all the different houses. And there's a lot actually going on here. They have a super pretzel spot. They've got a Stellar's tree trail. They've got the dancing light show in the middle of the lagoon. We saw a little bit of that. And also a little surprise maybe. I can't wait to tell you or show you guys this, but I am excited. I think now we're actually head on in to see Santa Claus. Hi, how are ya? Oh, very excited.
Hello, happy holidays.
This is Santa's house right here. And look at it, it's so beautifully themed, right? I love it. And then take a look right there. You got a sign that says Santa Claus is home. Santa Claus is home. And he's got a snowman out front. I don't think that's Frosty though. But this is so beautiful. Look at this. Look at the lights and the tree. I like it.
I highly suggest if you do plan a trip down to Walt Disney World during the holiday season or just at Orlando and you're looking for things to do, come here and take a stroll around and help support a great cause and look at some beautiful lights and enjoy some holiday cheer. Some fun facts, there is 1.25 million feet worth of lights and 3 million of those lights were donated by Walt Disney World. So like this is like a big thing, like I said, and I would say it's probably one of the biggest light displays actually in Orlando at the moment. I don't know where else can actually beat it. It's definitely more lights here than there is at Disney.
I mean, it has to be because Disney donated 3 million of them. 3 million of the lights. So like, I don't think Disney's got another 3 million lights laying around.
I'll put all the information in the description if you actually want to see about coming and visiting the Give Kids the World Village. And like I said, it's really good. I'm really happy to help promote it. Earlier they said that they were expecting like 10 to 12,000 people to visit last year. And through promotion and word of mouth and people actually spreading the word, 90,000 people actually came here. That is so amazing. 90,000 when they were expecting 10. Like, that's huge.
Look at this. We're walking in Santa's house here. It smells like gingerbread. It's like a Santa kitchen. Oh, I can see where the gingerbread's coming from. This is really, really nice.
You've got the guts. You can do what you
want to. Oh, yes. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Oh, come on in, young man.
Thank you, thank you. Just wanted to swing by your house, say hello. Thank you for the presents last year, and hopefully I get some this year.
Were you good this year?
I think so.
As opposed to last year?
Oh, no, I was good last year. That's why I got the presents.
Well, are you better this year?
Yes. That's the most important.
As an acceptable answer.
Oh, I like it. Your house is beautiful, though.
Thank you very much.
It's very well, nice and decorated. Lots of books.
Santa's well read.
And I like the furniture as well. It's very nice. Look, it's a nice couch.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Yes, let's do a photo. Yeah, absolutely.
He's definitely got a lot of people waiting to meet him, so we might swing back, but I just wanted to show you the inside a little bit. Like I said, it's not every day you get to see Santa's house.
Now we're gonna move along and check out some of the houses here. And look at this Hasbro one. Oh wow, Transformers, Potato Head, Peppa. And then right across from the Hasbro house, it looks like it's the world's most magical house. Look at that. This is beautiful. I love how they have the Small World mural back there. Yep, and dedicated by the Walt Disney World Resort. Right there is the sign. Wow. This is what a house would look like if Walt Disney World decorated it. That is pretty impressive. I like it, and I love how all the houses kind of match the paint color. Like the lights match the paint color. You'll see that, like when we get to the Home Depot house, you could probably guess what the colors of the Home Depot house will be.
Let me know in the comments what your favorite decorated house is of the night. I'm gonna try to show you them all, but there is a lot. So I'm gonna point out the ones that really stand out to me. And like I said, I want you guys to let me know which one's your favorite house. Like who did the best job?
We've got Margaritaville right here. It's 5 o'clock somewhere. Usually it's 5 o'clock here at this house. And then SeaWorld, actually right across the way there. Look at that. This one's nice and blue. And it's promoting Icebreaker, which is the new roller coaster that SeaWorld actually has coming out soon. Now we're coming up on the Universal Orlando Resort House. And look at all the Minions. They have a nice like photo opportunity out here. And also, there's something like projection in the windows. We're gonna have to take a closer look here. Oh, wow, the Minions are singing. They're doing caroling. That is really cool.
Holy moly, they even have carnival games here. That's really impressive.
Look at that. They have a water gun carnival game there. And here is the Enterprise rent-a-car house. And it's got a bunch of cars on it and a kind of like a lidded driveway. I've never seen that before. That's actually really cool. It looks like a runway, actually. That's very nice, though. I have not actually announced this yet, but for people that are coming to visit the village, there is an attraction here. Now, I don't think this is available for the public. I think it's just for people that are staying here, but there is an attraction where there is a character that I happen to be friends with here at the village, and it's really awesome, and it's really cool. He is my friend Franco, and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to show you him today, but if you see him, you might recognize his voice. He's in the attraction itself, and I'm very happy about that. Hopefully, if I can't show you today, and maybe you guys know what I'm talking about, I will show you eventually once I'm able to, because, you know, one thing is you don't want to disturb any of the families that are staying here, and that's why we're about to board a tram that's actually going to take us to the other side of the village where the families are staying, so we're not just walking up on like someone's lawn as they're enjoying their vacation down here. Because actually there would be families staying in all these houses. Over on this section there's no family staying in because this is brand new, and if there was a family staying in this house, I don't know how they would be able to sleep with that noise.
Should we like all play this?
Oh, should we race?
Yeah, let's race.
Yes, let's do it. We're gonna race. We're gonna get a bunch of people together and we're gonna race.
Yeah.
Looks like the showdown is happening here. We've got Jackie, super enthused. We've got Sam. We've got Vincent, Vincent Vision. And we've got Elsa. Yes. Yes, and we're about to race. Oh boy, we don't have to press anything, right?
Okay, go!
Oh boy, I'm number 5!
Number 9 to head down!
Oh, come on!
Number
9! Number 9? Who's number 9?
No, 7, 7 1. 7
1. That was really fun, and it's free to play. You just walk up and you play. Now, I don't think you win prizes. Maybe the kiddos do, but now we're gonna actually head to the tram. There's a couple houses on the way, though, I do wanna show you. Here is American Airlines, and look at that. There's a plane, actually, in the driveway, or the runway. That's really, that's pretty awesome. It's a gigantic American plane, and yeah, there's a lot, actually, here. Ooh, I wanna get my photo with that big Santa suit. Yeah. Yeah, did you?
Very flattering.
This is Ripley's, believe it or not. This was my favorite house last year, actually. I loved it. Like, this was so cool. Look at that. They've got the world's tallest elf. They got the Santa suit here. I love it. So many photo opportunities. I really thought those were people taking photos. It actually got me really well. I was definitely shocked. Wow. These are remarkable. Holy moly. Look at Grace right here. I'm so afraid one of them's gonna pop out and actually scare me. Like, what if they really do? It's not a real person.
I thought it was a real person.
It's not, I know, I was super scared. Okay. Yeah, that's not a real person. But like, doesn't this look real? Definitely a little scary. This is definitely gonna be one of my favorite houses, if not my favorite. Oh, and I forgot they have the upside down Christmas tree. I forgot about that last year. It's the upside down Christmas tree. Look at that. So awesome. I love it. It's like perfect. You know what I mean? For Ripley's Believe It or Not. And these are all gifts from Robert Ripley. Really cool. I kind of want an upside down Christmas tree. This is how Figment's Christmas tree would be if he celebrated the holidays at his house. Now that we've actually moved along, like I said, there was a couple houses on the way. Here is the line to actually get the choo-choo train or the tram to go visit all the other houses. And you can grab yourself some pretzels and looks like churros. Yeah, California churros right here. Look at that. Very convenient. So now we're actually loading onto the tram, and people are staying in these houses right here, I believe. Yeah, because you can see there's cars like in the parking lot. Looks like we got a PGA, a Perkins house. Not too sure what that one is. Oh, that's the Crayola one, because I can see some crayons standing up in the lawn right there. There goes the tram. There we go. We're boarding the tram here.
Wow, epic!
I like it. We're all loaded up, and we're still kind of trying to decide if it's a train or a tram. So we're gonna call it the train tram. And kind of, is this Edward Scissorhands?
Polar Express.
Is it? Oh, it does sound like Edward Scissorhands. I was like, wait a second. But there is a special celebrity narrator that's actually going to talk about the houses that we visit.
I'm Jody Benson. The Little Mermaid. On behalf of Give Kids the World Village. Look at that KitchenAid. Night of a Million Lights. This one-of-a-kind experience features a 360-degree dance-star light show, a sparkling tree trail, larger than life holiday. No cost. Sadly, more than 30,000 trees in the U.S. are dying.
Look at this. This is actually the Welcome Center here.
Get to work customizing the ultimate wish experience, tailored to each family's needs.
Isn't it so nice? So really, families in need get to come down here and stay in these beautiful homes and come to the theme parks. And it's just, it truly is amazing. Honestly, I absolutely love it. Oh, look at this right here. I love it so much.
Mayor Clayton's Wonder Lab. Ever wheelchair accessible carousel. Jurassic Junction. Jurassic themed train experience. Lori's magical flight. And Kelly's sunny swing. Another Paolo is Matthew's Bowman's Playground. Featuring the world's largest game of candy rings. And Jersey Jackson's Playroom, a Legoland Merlin's Magic Space. Feature films and animated movies can also be seen in Julie's Safari Theater. They also offer a beautiful nature trail for gardens, a koi pond, and a fishing pond. And who doesn't love ice cream? Henry's Starlight Spruce.
Well, that was really pretty, actually. I loved actually going through on the tram. It's a lot easier to see more of the houses, and I actually like it because it's guided through. And I also like the narration as well. And it was like overall just really pretty. Now we're actually gonna head back on over to the Christmas tree trail and then a little dessert party, but I think we have to go through Keaton's Corral here. I like it, isn't it so nice? Now we're heading through the Christmas tree trail here, and it's funny, I saved this one for last. I like this a lot. Hey friends. We got Stellar's tree trail, and it's so funny because Stellar and Franco were friends, so it's gonna be interesting. I can't wait to actually see that. And yeah, we're just gonna go through a very nice Christmas tree trail. And I think there's a TikTok going through the tree trail right now. Look at this. I love it. Isn't it so nice? Just going right through here. Amazing, right? Ooh, and they got a little treat section here with some Dippin' Dots. I like that a lot. This is really pretty. This is so awesome to walk through here. And I like the music. I think we got a little Dolly Parton here. Another offering they have here is kind of like a dessert party. So you can actually have some treats and enjoy the music and lights. And I don't know if this is an added thing, like something you actually have to pay extra for, but it looks really good. They've got cocoa kisses, little cookies, eclairs, lots of good items here. Brownies, that's a s'more brownie right there. Some tarts. And like I said, you get to eat treats with a view. And it's so pretty out. Look at this dessert party. I came back over on the other side. They have beverages here. It's so nice. And then more desserts. And then they've got ice cream in here. This is really, really cool. Is that soda?
Sprinkles.
Oh, sprinkles. You need sprinkles for the ice cream. Oh, no, no, I'm good. But I like it though, it's cool. So I just double checked and the dessert party is like a VIP package that you can actually purchase when you're here. And it's just open for us tonight because it's a media event and we're just showing you guys everything so you guys can come out and plan if you want to visit here. But it's really nice and honestly, everything's worth it here. Like I said, because everything goes to something so magical. So if you have the funds and you can buy it, doesn't matter if the price is worth it or not. It's just good to actually, you know, give back to a great cause. As you're walking around, you can hear some testimonies from family and kids that actually stayed here at the village.
To honor presents, find the Polar Express, eat cookies, watch Christmas movies, and eat popcorn.
Merry Christmas.
Another thing, if you can't actually afford to come and pay a ticket, you can always come and volunteer. They always need volunteers. It takes almost 150 people to run this event here just tonight. So that's 150 volunteers a night. And I will put all the information, like I said, in the description. You guys can check it out there. I'm actually gonna be volunteering here for a night of a million lights. And I thought about making it kind of public to let you guys know that if you wanted to come and see me, I'm gonna be here and I'm gonna do November 21st. So if you are in Orlando, the area, November 21st, I'm gonna be here at Give Kids the World Village and I'm gonna be volunteering and I would love to say hi to some of you. Now, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to spend a lot of time with you because I do wanna volunteer, so I'm gonna be working maybe the Boston Market stand, or I might be working the Icy stand or merchandise. Either way, I mean, I'm pretty sure it'll be enough time that I could say hi and it's just gonna be good and I wanna do that. And that's like the most important thing is I wanna actually give back and actually come here and help out and volunteer. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I enjoyed making it and I loved being here. I really love being here. It is so beautiful. And I hope that you guys plan on visiting and maybe volunteering in the future as well. We'll see you next time. Bye.